This is an introduction to the full-stack React Django DRF Channels project, DJ Chat. Like many of the courses here on the channel, you'll be able to follow much of this course here on the YouTube channel playlist. Of course, you can also purchase this course on Udemy. There's a link in the video description, which will generally provide you the best price for the course. As you probably have determined already from the title, this course is all about building a React front end, a Django DRF back end, using channels so that we can enable WebSockets to build a chat application. So I'll quickly talk about the structure of this course and then give you a technical preview. We'll have a look at what we're building and the code that we're developing. Now, the first thing you probably notice that this course is nearly 28 hours long. There is a few more tutorials I want to add to this. You can see that there's lots of things that are missing that I'd like to include, for example, testing. You can see that that probably would add another 6-7 hours to the course. Now, I keep asking myself, how is this 28 hours long? I'm not entirely sure, to be honest with you. One of the reasons probably why it is so long is because it's a full stack course. And of course, we're working on the front end and the back end. It's just very time consuming. Now, in addition to that, I have tried to explain and give you options, because not only I want you to follow along with this course, I'm trying to give you information so that you can then build upon your skills to actually be able to make your own customizations. There are some sections, for example, like the authentication section, where we try to work from the ground up. So we're learning the basics and then we add the layers on top of it. So that also, you can see here, 7 hours, that took quite a long time to explain and work through. So we start the course by building the chat server administration API. So that deals with actually managing the service so that they can be displayed to the users, so they can filter out different servers via category, for example, so that they can choose a server. So that all happens first, the back end, and then we move into the front end. So you can see there's 3 hours of front end templating, which is very exciting, of course. So here we're using Material UI. Again, it's such a time consuming task, the front end. We think about different aspects of our application. We're going to be implementing responsive fonts and breaking down the application into smaller components. So the templates that we create, we're going to be creating an approach where we are building small components, and that makes up the whole design. And by doing that, we're creating reusable components that we can utilize throughout the application. So I have now built a back end, if you like, and then a front end. We now talk about API integration. So here we're trying to connect our React application to the back end. There's a few things that we need to think about. Say, for example, cause. That's going to be crucial for us to understand. And then we move into start talking about Axios interceptors. Just a kind of an introduction there for us to then utilize later in authentication. We then start to build some custom hooks. So again, if you're new to React, I'm trying very much from the ground up to give you all the information you need to learn React at the same time build. So that's probably why, again, it takes a little bit more time than it would normally do if I were simply just to actually just show you the code. So you can see that we then start to integrate all this into the components and start to build up all the functionality of actually being able to show servers and being able to select different servers so users can select a server to then start chatting in that server. We have also included dark mode, so I'm not quite sure where it takes an hour. I think we had a very customized approach there to implementing dark mode. Right, so once we've got all that in place, we then start to think about the chat service. So we've got the kind of now the functionality for users to be able to access servers. So we're now focusing on the chat services. So here we're utilizing Django channels. So we'll learn about WebSockets, installing the servers that we're going to need, routing. So routing WebSockets, that's going to be important. And then, yeah, start to build the actual chat room. So again, from the ground up, assuming you've got no knowledge at all of that, we implement all of that, and then we need to implement kind of channel message history. So that's quite a large chunk of work that we need to do. And then we start to kind of build around that, making sure that we've got different aspects and features included. Now, again, what takes time here is that we're working on the back end and the front end. So once we've done the back end, we then need to move to the front end. You can see here's another round about an hour of actually then implementing that on the front end. So at this point, we've got everything in place in terms of the chat application. Then we can start to talk about authentication. So like I said, we work from the ground up. We're going to be utilizing JSON Web Tokens. So we take a look at that, build a simple implementation, and then we start to think about how to then utilize that within our application, protecting endpoints, protected routes, logging out users, logging in users, and then we move to then HTTP only cookies. So we kind of migrate over to that and customize simple JWT. So there's a lot of work there we need to do to customize the simple JWT app package, sorry, so we can then implement HTTP only. And we've taken this approach rather than, you know, just grabbing a package and installing it approach, because this is really going to give you a better idea of how to extend your applications to include different features, giving you that kind of fine control over the application. So once we've got general authentication in place, we then start to talk about WebSocket authentication. So we start to build a much bigger package, authentication package throughout the application. So WebSocket authentication, and then we need to think about refresh access tokens for both JWT and thinking about working with WebSocket. So there's a few different challenges to overcome. I tried to give you some different examples and chat over different approaches, as well as actually implementing the code. Right. So there's a bit of a cleanup work at the end here, removing cookies, handling login form validation, registration forms, etc. And then that leads us on to the last section, which I will add some more to, because there's loads more features that we can add at this point. There's probably another 28 hours easily here. But we started to build server memberships and think about those chat restrictions. I wanted to provide you a technical preview, which is really a walkthrough of everything that we've developed up until this point, which is around about 27 hours into the course. Hopefully that is going to give you all the information you need, whether you want to start this project or if it's just going to be a complete waste of your time. So what you're looking at here is the front end without any data at the moment. This is the framework that we are developing. Now, I'll add some data shortly so we can see that, but for now, I just wanted to show you this structure. So this is React front end and Material UI. You can see we've added some different features from Material UI, some drop downs. We're going to add light and dark mode. And if we drop into this, we can see that this is also going to be responsive. So we have responsive fonts, and you can see that we have started to think about the design structure here so that tools and services will still be available when or as and when the screen size scales. So it should be usable both in mobile as well as other screen sizes. Now the general principle here and how we're developing this interface is we're building small components. So what you're seeing here isn't one page, it's multiple components. And there are multiple pages to this application. This is just one of the pages, but we are trying to build components so that we can reuse them throughout our application. Right, so here in the back end, we're using Django administration. We haven't got to that point where we have thought about kind of front end administration of servers, etc. So we are going to be utilizing the Django admin site for now to maybe add some data and to just observe and use for troubleshooting. So here we're going to be building a set of tables for both the servers, categorizing servers. Each server has channels. Channels refers to chat rooms. So in this case, we can go ahead and build a simple category. So cat one description, if you like. You can add, of course, I'm going to show you how you can add additional fields and so on. I've tried to make this so it is expandable and you can customize it. There is icons here as well, which do work, but I'm not going to upload anything for now, just to show you this. So I'll just save that. Now, because of the dependencies, we need to build a category first, and then we can build a server. So this server entity, again, you can go ahead and customize this. So there must be an owner. We've added a category. There are members. So let's just say test. Again, it has a banner and icon, which I won't add for now, but it is usable. So press save. And then, like I said, in servers, we have channels. Those are chat rooms. So we need to add a few chat rooms. Now, eventually, we will be able to add channels and servers from the front end. So let's just call this channel one, some sort of chat room. Topic is general topic, and then we connect it to a server. So if and when we do that, right, so if I go back to the front end here, you can see that when we refresh, we can see all the new data. So on, this is the homepage of our application. There will be more data here if you added it, of course. So we have popular servers that can be changed. That's just kind of a placeholder. We have multiple categories here in the middle. Obviously, I've only added one for now. And on the right-hand side, these channels will appear depending on what category you select. So that's kind of the general setup. So users would select a server based upon their interest, and then they can go into the server. Now, anyone can access these servers. That's how we've set it up. But in order for them to actually chat in the server, they can see the chat, but they can't chat unless they're members, right? So that's the important thing to remember. And that's what we're going to be setting up. And of course, that will be adaptable to your own preferences and requirements. Now, inside of a server, we have channels. So channels are, this is very much like Discord, if you like. We've got chat rooms here. So they can select the chat rooms. There might be multiple of them. You can see that there are historical messages that will appear. And I can go ahead and say hi again and so on. So eventually, you will have multiple messages here. And you notice that we've sorted out the scroll. So it scrolls correctly from bottom to top. And it will show the latest message. So we have all that in place. Now, if the user wasn't a member, there is a membership button here. You can see it's fairly basic at the moment, but we're just adding the functionality, which there is going to be a lot of. We're very much focused on the code rather than the look of that at this point. But that's all in place so that we can become members of channels and remove ourselves. And that will then lead to more features that we can add in the application. So needless to say, although there is only one user here, if I were to open up a new browser, a new incognito browser, I can of course go ahead and log in as another user and then start chatting. So in this chat room, there might be multiple users. So if you're still wondering why that takes 27 hours to build, let me just show you some of the code in the back end and some of the different features that we are implementing. So you probably have already seen in the course structure, first of all, we start to build the chat server API. So again, that's in Django. So here we have the server API. So we'll be focusing on building all the components for our API. That requires us to, we're going to be building some sort of filter. So discussing how we can implement that to return different servers. So this is all associated to actually showing servers based upon categories and other parameters on the front page. So in addition to actually building that functionality, we'll take a look at how to document that. So we will be looking at customizing our schema so that we can add different parameters, custom parameters. We'll be utilizing Swagger UI. So Swagger UI is going to provide us an interface so that we can actually document our endpoints, our API, and potentially then utilize that when we're developing the front end. So this is the server backend related to the server filtering. There's a doc type, explain that and build that, as well as build this customization here so that we can input different parameters and test out our endpoints. There will be a need for us to understand a little bit about building tables and fields and connecting those tables, looking at different relationships. So here we have a basic setup of category, server, and channel, but you can see we built some additional customizations. And we look at capturing different signals so that we can customize, for example, in this case, look at how to create some filters and validators for images so that when we upload images, we can ensure that the correct types of images and sizes of images are being uploaded, as well as actually managing images should servers be deleted or categories be deleted. So by default, that isn't the case. So we have to think about those kind of details when working with images. Okay, so the second section of the course, looking at the front end template, this is going to take a fair bit of time. So in our React here, the structure we have here, we're going to create some different pages. So we have some kind of top level pages, so for example, the homepage here. And you can see that we're going to be utilizing or building a structure of templates and building these templates which build up the page to make this kind of modular approach. So on different pages, we'll be able to actually reuse we are to reuse many of these different templates. So we go ahead and build templates, take a look at and start to learn some of the different aspects of React, assuming that you have no idea at all about React. And of course, then we start to pile on layers in terms of implementing Material UI, and then start thinking about then connecting to our API. And that, of course, is the third section of this course, API integration. So like I said, here we start to think now about creating different features. So we create some different services. We can be utilizing some different context in order for us to share and centralize some of our different states in React. So we'll be learning about how to do that, as well as building API connections, managing and handling errors. We'll go ahead and in this course, at this point, we'll be utilizing a JWT interceptor to think about handling different errors, as well as then moving into handling refresh tokens when we start looking at security aspects. So before we start security, we're looking at authentication. We'll move into chat services. So here we're utilizing Django channels. Now it's amazing how very little amount of code we need to develop there. At this point, at least, to build a chat service. So if we go into web chat here, we're going to be, first of all, thinking about how to actually route WebSockets so that we can then build our consumer. And this consumer really isn't very large at the moment, but it will allow us to build multi-user rooms, multi-user communication. So a basic type of setup there. It will require us to eventually think about building a few different models so that we can store a history of the communication within these different server channels. And then the course moves on to authentication. So here we're going to be utilizing simple JWT, creating an authentication process using JSON Web Tokens. So originally, I'll take you through the process so you get a better idea of the workflow of JSON Web Tokens, and then we move into deeper aspects, as I've probably already mentioned, looking at creating a setup with HTTP-only cookies. Now, that will require some extensive work in terms of extending the simple JWT package. So we will go ahead and do exactly that so that we can set up a way of creating our cookies, and we'll learn all different kind of settings for that, and that will then lead us into cores so that we can actually build those connections successfully, as well as then thinking about how to actually manage that on the front end. One of the key points that we're looking at is how to manage the refresh token so that we can automatically ensure that users aren't logged out, for example, every couple of minutes utilizing the access token. So definitely a lot of work there, and it will take us time to kind of build up towards HTTP-only cookies. So this course isn't just all about me just telling you how to do it. I do try and explain process. We do think about different approaches. Because I do want you to feel by the end of this course that not only you can just follow step by step, but you can start to explore how to expand, how to change, to adapt to your own requirements.